Dear friends, welcome back. Now, let us see how the transistor is operative in the three configurations. There are actually three configurations named as common base, common emitter, common collector. The voltage or current amplification. What is amplification? The amplification is achieved by passing the input current from region of low resistance to region of high resistance. This concept of transfer of resistance gives the name transfer resistor. So short, we can call it as a transistor. The small amplitude is applied to the base to get the magnified output signal at the collector. So we have the NPN transistor and the PNP transistor. We have seen already the symbols are here. Again, go back. This is the PNP transistor. This is the NPN transistor. For both the transistor types, the terminals are same. In the P type, holes are majority charge carriers, and in N type, the electrons are majority charge carriers. It is a current controlled device. Now let us see after the configuration and what is amplification. A very important parameter of a transistor is the use of transistor as a amplification. Now let us see the importance of the biasing to the transistor. We can connect the transistor to a bias. Bias is required to operate the transistor in a stabilize and gives the amplification at the output. The transistor action can be studied by using unbiased transistor and the biased transistor. In the above figure, you can see here, this is the figure for the unbiased. Unbiased means what? There is no connection or external bias connected to the transistor. Here again you can see we have the N type, where we have the electrons are majority charge carriers. This is the P type, that is nothing but the base, and this is the N, nothing but the collector. So emitter is a heavily doped compared to the collector, and the hole and the holes which are present in the P region are called as a minority charge. It is a narrow and lightly doped. So we are forming here two junctions. One junction is between emitter and base, that is called as the EB junction, and one more junction is formed between the collector and base. So that is called as a CB junction. So already we have discussed about the junctions which is formed in a diode. The same, like that same diode junction, here also we are forming the diode. Here also we are forming the junctions similar to the diode. As I told, the transistor is nothing but two diodes connected back to back. In the unbiased transistor, means there is no external connection connected to the transistor, that is nothing is connected to the emitter and base and between the base and collector. So there is no current from any transistor leads because of the no connection of the external voltage or bias to the transistor. Biasing is required to stabilize the transistor and give the faithful operation as an amplifier. So let us see in the biased transistor. In the biased transistor, as we require the amplifier, it acts as an amplifier, means low signal had to be amplified and we have to increase the magnitude of the input signal. So we have to connect the external, we have to connect the external voltage. So that connection of the external voltage to the transistor is called as a bias. So depending upon the external bias, voltages, the polarities used to connect the voltages to the transistor in the three regions. So the regions here you can see in the table, the region first column, then the EBJ means electron means emitter base junction, and the third column is called as a CB means the voltage connected between collector and base junction. So there are three regions of operation named as a active region, cutoff region, saturation region. So in active region you can see the EB means emitter and base connected in forward bias, and the collector and base connected in the reverse bias. In the cutoff region, emitter base connected reverse bias, whereas collector base connected in reverse bias, means both input circuit and output circuit both are in reverse bias. In saturation region, the input is connected in forward bias and the output is connected in the forward bias. I think you are getting my point. Forward bias means the n-type have to be connected to the negative terminal of the battery, and the positive terminal of the base we have to connect it to the positive terminal of the battery, then it is called as a forward bias. Reverse bias means the polarities are opposite. So here you can see one circuit for the active region. Again you can see we have the NPN transistor, which is a widely used one of the configuration of the transistor, where you can see we can connecting the N to the negative terminal of the battery called as VEE. So here you can see that this negative is connected to the N type, and the positive terminal here you can see connected to the base, nothing but the P type. So this is a positive, and the P is also the holes, means it is a positive, it makes the forward bias. Both the polarities are same, N means negative, and this is the battery VEE is also negative, so this circuit makes the forward bias. So the external supply which is connected is called as a VEE. Because of this, we are flowing the current in the circuit called as a emitter current, that is IE, and the voltage developed across this circuit is a VBE with negative and positive terminals. You can see the polarity of the base current, that is IB. Okay, then here you can see collector and again the base. The collector is N type and the base is a P type. Here you can see the P type is connected to negative terminal, and the negative terminal of the N is connected to the positive terminal by applying the VCC. This circuit makes the reverse bias. Are you getting? This is the reverse bias. N is connected to positive, means it is a reverse bias. So this is the reverse bias and this is the forward bias. So this circuit connection is called as a active region connection for the NPN transistor. So similarly you can get the connection for this. So you can see here for the direction of current, that is IC. So there are total three currents are flowing in a circuit. One is a emitter current denoted as IE, then IB, that is a base current, then the collector current called as IC. So total current is IE equal to IB plus IC. Okay, if you are sending 100 electrons from the emitter side, you are getting the 95% at the collector side, and the 5% are recombined in the holes. So if you are sending 100, then you are getting the 95 in the collector and 5 in the base region because of the electron and hole recombination, and because of the thin junction and the lightly doped of the P, where in a base region, here you can see in the base region the electrons and holes are recombined here because of thin and lightly doped, 5% are lost here, and we are getting 95% in the collector. So that you can see here in this figure. So electron flow across the emitter base junction
Again, you can see this circuit here. Here, this is a negative terminal, and this is the RE. This is called as a RE, means resistance connected to the emitter side. This is a current limiting resistor. We have to limit the current at the emitter. So again, we have the N. This is the P, and this is the N. Again, we are making NPN. Here you can see BE. Then here you can see the BC. BE means base and emitter. BC means base and collector. Forward bias. This is the collector. This is the forward bias. This is the reverse bias. Here a BE junction is formed. Here the BC junction is formed. BE means base emitter junction. BC means base and collector. Base and collector junction. Again, here we can see the RC. This is the RC. This is the resistance connected to the collector terminal, and this is the current limiting resistor. Again, you can see the positive and negative, and here the positive and negative. Negative side is connected to the negative terminal. Positive is connected to the positive terminal of the base. This makes the forward bias. This makes the reverse bias. This circuit makes the reverse bias. So this is called the active region operation. There you can see the flow of electrons. Here in junction, you can see these are electrons flowing towards the junction. Here we have the immobile ions. Already we discussed about immobile ions in the space charge region in a diode. So recall that one. Here you can see the plus sign, plus positively charged immobile ions, and here negative charge. Again, this is the P type. You can see here the width of the base junction. And here you can see the width of the BE, width of the BC from this to this, and here you can see this to this. So here can you observe that the width of the base to collector is very high compared to the width of the space charge region or depletion region in a BE here, BE junction, towards the BE junction. Why? Because the electrons are heavily doped compared to the collector. Collector is moderately doped, and electrons are N side or emitted side is heavily doped. Because of that, you can see the very large or widened space charge region in the towards the CB compared to the junction or wide junction formed in a BE. So this is called as a electron flow across the EB junction. So similarly, we are getting the same in the CB junction. We have seen similarly, we are getting in the same phenomena is there in a PNP type. So here you can observe the current directions. Again, we are discussing about the NPN, means N is a emitter, P is a base, and N is a collector. Similarly, the current directions, the VEE, VCC, and the current direction what we are seeing here, like IE, IC, IB, all the directions and polarities are changed in the PNP type. So please remember, in PNP type the polarities are reversed, because the P here I will show. Let us assume this is the P, means this is the positive side. So here, instead of negative, we have to connect here the positive. Means this, then this, we have to reverse it. Are you getting? So instead of the IE flowing in this direction, so the IE is flowing in the clockwise direction. So everything is reversed in the PNP type. Okay. So let us see in next class the different configurations that was discussed in the next class. Okay. Thank you.